Okay, good day everybody. Once again, we have another session for today. We will be having a topic, timely rin sa mga nagtitake ng accountancy and any accounting subject this sem, bonds payable. Particularly with detachable warrants and convertible bonds. It is an illustrative problem solving, so we will not prolong this. Let's go on with the illustration. A problem will be solved and accounting for bonds will be demonstrated, no, in detail. So let's go to the problem. Okay, we have three problems here. Simulan natin itong una. Ang ating first problem reads, on December 31, 2020, Troy Company issued 5 million face value 5-year bonds at 109. Each 1,000 bond was issued with 50 detachable share warrants, each of which entitled the bondholder to purchase one ordinary share of 5 par value at 25 pesos. Immediately after the issuance, the market value of each warrant was 5 pesos. The stated interest on the bonds is 11%, payable annually every December 31st. However, the prevailing market rate of interest for similar bonds without warrant is 12%. So the requirements, journal entries, no, to record the following: issuance of the bonds with share warrants, and next is exercise of all the share warrants. So ang ating solving dito in this situation, ano, an exercise yung share warrants. As we go back to the main title, ano, we will be tackling and focusing on how these detachable warrants, no, influence and they affect the accounting for bonds payable. The same with convertible bonds. Okay, so let us solve yung first problem natin, ano. So I have here all the solutions. All I have to do now is to explain it to you, to make it clear and to be able to get the techniques on how to do it. Okay, so dito sa ating solution, ano, we have the following journal entries and the computation. So we will show you. Okay, so dito sa ating entry, we have a debit to cash 5 million, ano, times 1.09. Okay, that should be the debit. Okay, and we all know that this 1.09, ano, indicates the fair market value or the total cost of the issuance of the bonds. So the issue price is 1.09, so 5 million, it resulted to 5,450,000. So we also have a debit of discount, may discount tayo na 180,221, and we have a credit of bonds payable indicating our liability, you know, indicating the liability on the part of the issuer. Okay, and this is an investment on the part of the shall we say the investor, okay, and a credit to share warrants outstanding to 630,221. Okay, so for us to better understand, I will show you the computation. Ito yung computation, paano natin nakuha yung journal entry. So, in this case, since hindi talaga sinabi, no, ang present value or fair value ng ating bonds, hindi talaga sinabi sa problem. In this case, all we have to do is we will have to get the carrying value at the time of the issuance. So, ang present value ng bonds is computed basing din naman sa information, no? Sabi, on the time of the issuance of the bonds, the effective interest rate on this type of transaction is 12%. This is the effective interest rate for 5 periods. Actually, the bonds will mature at after 5 years. So, ang present value ng ating one-time payment sa ating bonds at 12% ay 0.56743. So, ito yung naging result natin after multiplying the 5 million by the present value of 1 at 12% for 5 periods. Tapos, we have to consider also the interest. Since the problem says that the bonds is having an 11% stated interest rate. Yun, yan. So, ang 11% interest rate ay nagkakahalaga ng 550,000. So, we will multiply it by the present value of annuity since the interest is being paid annually. So, limang beses na magbabayad yung issuer ng bonds ng interest. So, for 5 periods, using the effective interest rate of 12%, the present value of annuity is 3.60478. So, the amount is 1.982629. So, in millions. Okay? So, the total amount, which is the carrying value at the time of the bond issuance, is 4,819,779. Okay? So, that's how this discount come from, you know, this is how the discount on bonds payable, you know, is computed, because the present value of the bond is 4,819,779, you know, deducted from the face value, no, and the difference is 180,221. That is what we call the discount on bonds payable. Okay, tapos kukunin mo yung share or yung particular portion ng proceeds para sa share warrants outstanding. Actually, based sa problem kasi, no, a warrant, no, is present in this particular transaction. For each 1,000, there is a 50 detachable share warrants. Okay? So, meron talaga siyang share warrant. Mamaya ko compute natin yung warrants, ano, kung paano natin ma-account kung ilan talaga ang naging warrants that will allow the issuer to purchase if ever i-exercise niya yung kanyang right, no? Okay? So, yun ang formula dito, paano nakuha ang discount, no? And also, yung ating share warrants is computed by getting the issue price of 5,450,000. You will deduct the present value of the bonds. So the difference will be allotted for the share warrants outstanding. So that's how we get the share warrants outstanding. I hope you understand this, ano? Dahil meron naman tayo computation on how to do it, no? So yan ang naging entry and the computation for the issuance of the bonds. Now let us go to number two, the exercise of the bond, no? The exercise of the bond. How are we going to account, journalize this transaction? Okay, so the entry here is 250,000 times 25 pesos, 6,250,000, and we debited the share warrants outstanding because based doon sa problem ay in-exercise lahat, no? You know? Okay. Sabi dito kasi, no? Immediately after the issue at the market value of each warrant is 5 pesos. Okay. Pero, however, sabi ganun, the prevailing market rate of interest for similar bonds without warrants is 12%. So, yeah, ito nga yung ginagamit natin, effective interest. But, ultimately, hindi naman yan ang nagiging focus, kundi the exercise of all the share warrants, no? Okay? At nakalagay naman dito yung option niya, no? That he will be allowed to purchase at 25, ano, yung 5 par na ordinary share. So, ang question kasi dito is, ilan, no? Ilan? So, this is how we can compute that. Let us see. No, yan. Sabi kasi, meron kang bonds na 5 million. Ang face ng bawat bond certificate ay 1,000. So, i-divide natin. No? When we divide the 5 million by the per certificate, ano, ang per certificate ng bond, no, ay 1,000 face value, no? So that means to say we have 5,000 bonds na mayroong detachable warrant na each bond mayroon siyang 50 detachable warrant. So 5,000 times 50, we have 250,000 detachable warrants, no? So it is also equal to the number of ordinary share na pwedeng bilhin. So equal siya sa ordinary share na allowed siya na bilhin, ano, at 25 pesos. So if the issuer, ano, if the rather the investor exercise yung right niya to purchase, ang magiging proceed ay 6,250,000. That is 250,000 times 25 pesos, kaya 6,250,000. Also at the same time, meron tayong computation dito ng mga share premium, no, for ordinary share, no? Kasi So, ang proceed natin, 6,250,000, ginamit yung share warrants because all of the warrants are exercised. Kasi, yun ang sinabi sa ating problem. Kaya, we will debit all the share warrants. No? Kasi, ginamit siya lahat. So, ang kanyang credit naman, that is 250,000 shares times 5 pesos. Ito at par ito eh. At par. No? Ito yung tinatawag na at par. Kaya, yan ang magiging sorry. Yan ang magiging kanyang credit. Okay? At par siya. So, ang difference nito ay magiging share premium. So, ito nga yun, ano? Yung proceeds, deduct natin yung rather, i-add muna natin yung share warrants outstanding, that is the total cost, no? Kung ating i-consider, ano? Yan ang total cost no exercise no warrants. I-less natin yung par value ng ordinary share. So, the difference is share premium. So, yun yung share premium natin. Okay? So, all in all, yan na yung ating requirements for 5-1. Number 1, yung issue ones. No, ito yung ating computation, ano? Okay. Present value, carrying value, I mean, and the issue price, okay? So the excess or the excess of the issue price will go to the share warrants, ano? Will be allocated to the share warrants, no? To recap. Dito naman sa exercise ng share warrants, so we'll just get the proceeds, which we also get the par value, no? And don't forget, we will cancel the share warrants outstanding, we debit it because it is a credit. So the difference will go to the share premium. Ito rin naman ang computation. Again, 5 million multiplied by the base amount for every certificate of the bond, that is 5,000 bonds, no certificates, multiplied by 50 because each certificate has 50 warrants. So 250,000 warrants, which will allow him to purchase one ordinary share, no, at 25 pesos. So the total of which is 6,250,000. Again, ang ating namang share premium, no, yung ating proceeds for the exercise, i-add natin yung ating share warrants because all of them are exercised, and i-less natin yung par value, and the difference will be the premium for ordinary shares. Okay, so that's for number 1. Okay, we will now go to the problem 5-2. Yang company issued 5,000 convertible bonds. No, this is now for conversion. Convertible bonds naman tayo. At the beginning of the current year, the bonds had a 4-year term, stated rate, interest is 6%, and were issued at par with face value of 1,000 per bond. So, interest is payable annually on December 31st, each bond is convertible into 50 ordinary shares with a par value of 10. Okay, the market rate of interest on similar convertible bonds is 9%. The issue date is what date it was? It actually walang sinabi dito ng date, no? At the beginning of the current year, okay? So January 1st, okay? So, Sabi dito, 485,000 ang na-credit sa share premium from conversion privilege. The bonds were not converted. Instead, binayaran, ano, paid off the convertible bond holders at maturity. So, sige, gawin din natin ang ating journal entries at saka ang computation. Okay? So, first, let us do the computation. Ang mga kailangan nating i-compute. At this point, yung sa ganong klaseng problem, ano, since wala siya talagang given na fair value, ano, okay, ang binigay na fair value is the interest, effective interest rate, but the bonds payable value itself, wala. So, we will get the present value of the bonds. Okay? So, here it goes. Sa ating computation, fair value or present value at 9% for 4 periods, ang ating present value at 9% is 0.70843. So, ang ating present value for the 5 million is 3,542,000 and 150. Okay, then ang ating present value naman ng interest, no, at 9% for 4 periods again ay 971,916 for a total of 4,514,066. Yan ang present value ng ating bonds payable. Okay, so I will show you now the entries. Dahil nakuha na natin ang present value nga ng ating bonds payable. So, ang magiging debit natin, so, kaya ito may highlight, this is going to be the balancing figure kasi hindi naman ibinigay ang cash. So, ito ang ating i-compute. Since the problem said na mayroong credit sa share premium, yan ang ating i-credit. Also, i-credit din natin yung 5 million. So, 5 million 485 na ang ating credit. Okay? So, since we really have to account, no, kung ano ang present value talaga ng bonds, since nakuha naman natin ang present value, ay we can now easily get the discount. Kung ang present value ng ating bonds ay 4,514,066 and the face is 5 million, so this is the difference. 485,934, yun ang ating discounts on bonds payable. So more or less, alam na natin, ano, no, makukuha na natin ang ating proceeds sa cash. So that is 5 million plus 485 minus 485,934, ito na ngayon yung nakuha natin proceeds, 499,066. That completes the journal entry. Okay? Balikan natin, 485, that is given naman, anong given siya. So, that will be the journal entry for the issuance. Okay? Then, the next one, payment at maturity. Hindi an exercise, ano, yung conversion privilege, hindi ginamit. So, we all know, at maturity, ang bonds niya ay equal na to the face amount. Always remember that. When we say at maturity, the bonds payable is now equal to the face amount. So, ang face or carrying value niya at that point in time ay 5 million na rin dahil fully amortized na siya. And we all know that every year ano magbabayad ka ng interest for the bonds payable. So in this case ang ating interest ay 300,000, that is for 6%. Ayun, no, 300,000, no, yun ang ginamit natin sa pag-compute ng annuity. So 300,000 kasi nga at maturity at that point every year end magbabayad ka talaga, no, at that last period, no, we really still have to pay the interest for the bonds payable. So ang total natin na debit ay 5,300,000, credit cost 5,300,000. And also we will now cancel na yung ating yan, no, 485 share premium conversion privilege. Since hindi siya nagamit, ika-cancel mo na yan, no? Ide-debit mo na yung privilege at i-credit mo na yung share premium for the particular entry, no? Yun na, para ma-cancel na siya. Okay? So that's how it is sa 5-2. We have the computation and the entry, no? Ang ating cash again ay 499,066. It is the difference or the balancing figure for this following or the figures, no, na known na, I mean given na. Okay, sige. Then we will now go to 5-3. Okay? 5-3. Ang 5-3, no? On January 1st, 2020, okay, issued a convertible bonds with face amount of 5 million for 6 million. Okay? Bonds are convertible into 50,000 shares at or with 100 par value. The bonds have 5-year life with 10% stated interest rate payable annually every December 31st. Fair value of convertible bonds without conversion option is computed as at 5,399,300 on January 1st, 2020. On December 31st, 2022, convertible bonds were not converted but fully paid. That means to say this is a sample of payment before maturity. So sa 2022 pa lang binayaran na, no? At ang ating outstanding balances at that particular date, no, 2022 is the bonds ay meron siyang no, ang ibig sabihin dito ang payment, no, ay 5,550,000, no, ito yung full payment, no. On such date the fair value naman ng bonds na wala yung conversion privilege ay 5,400,000 and the carrying amount naman ng bonds ay 5,178,300. So journal entries din sa issuance at saka sa settlement. This is a settlement before maturity date. Okay, ito naman ang ating solution dyan. Again, this is a video, no? You can go back, no, again and again to the solution and go back to the problem, no? Diba? Dali nyo siyang matitrace. Ito yung mga solution for 5-3. Okay, we compute. We get the proceeds from the bond, 6 million. Given yan, ang fair value ng conversion of conversion bonds ay convertible. Rather, ano, convertible bonds at January 1st, 2020 ay 5,399,300. Given yan, no? Given, no? We will go back here. Given siya, 5,399,300. Okay, so ang ating fair value ng equity portion, ano, yun nga yung tinatawag na conversion privilege for the purchase of share, additional share of stock, ay 600,700. Okay, so yun lang ang gagawin mo, i-proceed, i-less mo yung fair value at that issuance ng bonds. So yun ang magiging fair value naman ng equity component no conversion privilege. So entry 6 million bonds payable syempre at par no at the face amount. Tapos since sinabi 5,399,300 ang face or fair value, that means to say ang premium on bonds is 399,300. So the difference, no, ang atin na lang vacant dito or the question mark account is the share premium, no, conversion privilege. So ito na nga yon, 600,700 na yun din ang nakuha natin dito sa computation sa taas. Okay, so yan ang magiging entry mo. Okay, yan ang entry. So since babayaran siya sa before maturity at given naman yung mga data, no, ang sabi bonds payable babayaran, edi i-debit mo yung 5 million premium on bonds, debit to 178,300. This is the remaining premium kasi ina-amortize yan eh, nung ina-amortize yan hanggang 22, no, 2022, ito na lang natitira sa premium on bond. So since siya ay babayaran, kakancelin mo na rin yan. Ang debit premium conversion privilege is 150,000. We will have the computation dito sa baba. And the loss on extinguishment of bond is 221,700. And the credit cost, 5,550,000. Ito ang computation sa baba. Kunin mo ang fair value ng bonds, no, at the time na payment, no? Sabi 5,550,000 daw ang fair value, which is given din dito sa taas yun, ha? Given yun, ngayon 5,550,000 given, no? Okay, also all the amounts, no, the fair value without the conversion privilege and also the carrying amount, given naman siya. So ito lang ang presentation on how to use them, no? Itong gagamitin mo, no? Fair value ng bonds sa conversion with conversion privilege, 550 or 5,550,000. Fair value na walang conversion privilege, so i-allocate mo yung natitira para sa equity. So 150, yan. Kaya yun din ang naka-debit dito because yun din ang allocation of the total payment, no, allocation. Ang allocation, that is you assign the 5,400,000 para dun sa bonds and the remaining goes to the premium conversion privilege. We must not forget na ang ating talagang original balance ng conversion privilege ay 600,700, ah. But at the time ng payment, ito lang ang ating i-allocate doon sa binayaran natin. Ito lang ang ating kakanselin. For that matter, yan, 150,000. Also, kailangan din natin kunin kung may loss or gain. Ang ating binayaran para doon sa without conversion privilege ay 5,400,000. Ito yun, no? For the bonds without conversion privilege. Tapos ibangga natin yung carrying amount naman ng bonds at the time of payment natin. So we must understand ng ating fair value, that means to say this is the payment na gagawin natin, 5,400,000, pero ang carrying amount lang ng ating bonds ay 5,178,300. That means to say may loss tayo. Sir, paano naging loss? Kasi ang ating inallocate na payment para dyan ay 5,400,000. $5,000, samantalang ang carrying amount lang ay 5,178,300. So we pay more than the carrying amount ng ating utang. Again, mas malaki ang ating allocation ng payment kaysa sa ating carrying value ng ating bonds payable. So may loss tayo, 221,700. Ito 'yon, naka-debit din. So, and we will credit the cash. Yan ang total nating payment na gagawin. That is 5,550,000. Okay? So, again, since na ang ating equity component or shall we say the conversion privilege is 600,700 at ang ating na-allocate lang, no, for the payment ay 150,000, we had to cancel, no, kakancelin natin na yung ating tinatawag na conversion privilege, no. Okay, share premium. Let us see, no, kung meron na dito, baka yan ay may entry na. Wala. Okay. So, lalagyan natin. Kasi we have to cancel the share premium conversion privilege. Ito yun. Ilan pa natitira? 600,700 minus 150,000. So, kakancel na natin yung 450,700 and we will credit the share premium, no, issuance. It will go back to the basic, sabi nga natin, 450,700 to cancel na yung conversion, nawala na yung conversion privilege for the yung right natin to convert it into share of stock. So, that's how it's going to be, no? Ganun lang naman kasimple ang magiging entrada niyan. Okay? So, that's all for the bonds payable, no? Featuring convertible and detachable. This is convertible bonds and detachable warrants, ano? Okay? So, I hope medyo nugget naman natin, ano? Ganun lang naman siya. Okay? So, thank you very much again for this opportunity to share it with you. And this is another version ng ating accounting in 30 minutes. So, hope to see you again. And lagi ko sinasabi, subscribe to the channel for more videos and tutorial sa accounting. Hit lang natin yung ating notification bell. So, see you again. Keep safe and good day, everybody. Bye.